the increased power for use that is open to us if we will but cease to be an obstruction. Freedom within the limits of nature's laws. And indeed there is no freedom without those limits, is best studied and realized in the growth of all plants, in the openness of the branch of a vine to receive the sap from the main stem, in the free circulation of the sap in a tree, and in all vegetable organisms. Imagine the branch of a vine endowed with the power to grow according to the laws which govern it, or to ignore and disobey those laws. Imagine the same branch having made up its vegetable mind that it could live its own life apart from the vine, twisting its various fibres into all kinds of knots and snarls according to its own idea of living, so that sap from the main stem could only reach it in a minimum quantity. What a dearth of leaf, flower, and fruit would appear in the branch. Yet the figure is perfectly illustrative in the way which most of us are interfering with the best use of a life that is ours. Freedom is obedience to law. A bridge can be built to stand only in obedience to the laws of the mechanics. Electricity can be made a useful power only in exact obedience to the laws that govern it. Otherwise, it is most destructive. Has man the privilege of disobeying natural laws only in the use of his own individual powers? Certainly not. And why is it that, while recognizing and endeavoring to obey the laws of physics, of mechanics, and all other laws of nature in his work in the world,